Hi guys, how are you? Happy Thursday! Wow, it's a gorgeous day out here, and anyway, it's gorgeous. Happy Thursday. So I wanted to come and talk to you today about what's in my beauty bag. Let's see if you guys can see. I put together a little bag of stuff for all of you to see. This is kind of an inside my little A bag. This is something new I'm trying, I'll go over it. But this is my makeup. So we'll go over everything on a regular basis, from what I wash my face with, to how I exfoliate, to how I moisturize, to what I put on my body, my little nighttime ritual, what I do if I get a pimple, all of it. Let's see. So I have all my stuff. Okay. So if you've been following me for a while, you know that I always say what you put on your skin gets into your bloodstream in less than a minute. So you better be choosing products that are super clean and super non-toxic. I have a list of the top 12 ingredients you should be avoiding. I'm going to post it in the comments below after this is over, because I was rushing to get here and I didn't get to pull it up. And since we redid my site, I can't find the document right now, so I have to spend a little time finding it, and then I'm going to post it. But things like parabens and sulfates and fragrance and PEGs, these things are all really, really, really toxic. And are also all shown to be endocrine disrupting agents. So that means that they disrupt our hormones. Male and female, they disrupt our hormones, which is not a good thing. Whether you're trying to get pregnant or not, it doesn't really matter. It's the endocrine disruption can be really detrimental to your health on every level. And there's also research showing that a lot of these agents are cancer causing, they trigger autoimmune diseases in patients. So there's an interesting statistic. Well, there's two. The average woman is exposed to 500 chemicals before she leaves her house in the morning, just because of her bath and beauty routine. 500 chemicals. That's outstanding and obnoxious and unnecessary, completely unnecessary. There are so many amazing products out there that, as I say, are pure enough to eat. So if you are going to put it on your skin, you better be able to actually know what each and every ingredient is, be able to read it, identify it, know where it came from, and I say even eat it. Another interesting statistic is that since, I believe it's the 1980s, we have introduced over 80,000, almost 100,000 new chemicals into our environment. And also, in that same time frame, since the 1980s, the incidence of autoimmune conditions, which cancer is also an autoimmune condition, as is like Hashimoto's, thyroiditis, Graves' disease, lupus, rheumatoid arthritis, celiac disease, fibromyalgia, cancer, all of these things are considered autoimmune conditions. So since we've introduced all these chemicals, right, since the 80s, nearly 100,000 chemicals, about 80 to 100,000, the incidence of autoimmune conditions has quadrupled and affecting women 75% more than men. And it's affecting women in their prime. So 20s, 30s, 40-year-old women are getting really affected by all these chemicals in our bath and beauty products. And it's because most of these chemicals are endocrine disrupting chemicals. So that means they disrupt hormones. And women's hormonal profile changes literally week to week. Whereas men are pretty stable, we change every week depending on where we are, which phase of our menstrual cycle. And so we're really susceptible to the effects that these chemicals have, the negative effects. And then, you know, back it up, if you are trying to get pregnant, or if you are currently pregnant, or breastfeeding, or really just want to be your healthiest self, know that these chemicals get into your bloodstream. And so if you're trying to get pregnant, then they're affecting the bloodstream that's going to affect the health of the egg that you create to create your baby. They're going to affect the quality of the sperm of your partner. When you are pregnant, it gets into your bloodstream and affects the baby in utero. And in fact, there's a good amount of science detailing how these toxic chemicals are really affecting babies' when they're in utero and their ability to get their fertility down the line. So it's very scary and concerning. And then also that it triggers autoimmune conditions in the babies. So something to really think about, especially with men too, the chemicals in their bath and beauty products, their bath and beauty routine, get into their bloodstream, affect their quality of health. So it's really no joke. And also, you know, for me, I have a child now, right? And I went through a pregnancy and I prepared my body to get pregnant as well. And at the age of 40, conceived easily and naturally after 2 months of trying. And I was very conscious of everything I've been putting on my skin for many years. After writing my first book, Chill Out and Get Healthy, which is back here somewhere. Let me grab it so I can show you. This is my first baby, Chill Out and Get Healthy. This is when I talked about all the harsh chemicals in our bath and beauty products. And after writing the book, like, I learned so much more than I thought I knew, which is always what happens when you write a book. You know, people often say you become the expert by writing the book. And it's very true. I made a commitment to myself that I would no longer put anything on my body that wasn't actually edible. And so from that was born my own skincare line called Amy Rout Beauty. I'm going to get to nail polish in a second, Natalie, so hang tight. I have that in my lovely, beautiful, monogrammed AE bag. This is from 31. My lovely Beth gave this to me. Anyway, so I created Amy Rout Beauty. And the first product I ever created for Amy Rout Beauty, this is my beautiful new packaging. Isn't it so pretty? I'm so in love with these new blue labels. I'm just in love. And this gold here, oh my God, I love it. So this is another one of my babies. And this is my, you can't really read this, but this is my organic anti-aging facial oil, which was the first product I ever created right next to my body butter. Here's my Amy Rout Beauty body butter. Nice big tub of that. These were the first two products ever because I made products that I needed, right? So supply and demand, right? Create what I needed so that I could also be the guinea pig and try all this out so that then I could tell you guys that it works. The organic anti-aging facial oil is the best for my skin type. It's pretty thick. It's made of ghee, which is clarified butter, coconut oil, olive oil, and then there's some other oils in there like kokui nut oil and rosehip seed oil, and some essential oils, all of which are really good for nourishing, hydrating, promoting circulation and blood flow, collagen production in the skin. And not only does it smell good and feel amazingly luxurious when you put it on, but it actually works. It's effective. Ever since I started using this product, I made this product for myself, didn't start selling it or packaging it, but then people started telling me all the time about how amazing my skin looked, how amazing your skin looked. And the guy I was dating at the time was a very entrepreneurial man, and he said, you need to package that stuff and sell it, because he started using it, and he was like, this stuff's amazing, you know, you need to package it and sell it. So I did, and, you know, and then I tweaked it a little bit, made it even more, you know, put in even more effective ingredients, if you will. So that was the first oil I made, and then from there I created a balancing oil and a nourishing facial oil for different skin types. So my assistant at the time, Heather, who's now my associate in my NIAC practice, she had more problematic skin, like acne-prone skin, and so the anti-aging facial oil was too thick for her skin. It would cause her to break out. So I created a formulation for her skin, and then I had one that's for every acne-prone patient, and it works wonders, and so she loved that oil. Then I had another friend who had skin similar to me, but not as a tendency to dry, and the anti-aging was almost too thick to apply, because I apply it morning and night. It was too thick for her to apply daytime, so I created my nourishing facial oil, which has similar properties to the anti-aging, but it's not as thick. It doesn't have the ghee in there, basically, and so it's a lighter daytime facial oil. So anyway, I basically created products that people needed and asked me to create, and so now, as you can see, this isn't even my entire line, but all the products that I use on a regular basis. So here we go. I clean my face every day with my Argan Oil Facial Cleanser, which I am absolutely obsessed with. And once was talking to a beauty considered a real expert in the field, and she was giving me consulting advice on my skincare line. And she loves my cleanser, like loves it. And she has access to every single, every single organic, all natural, edible skincare product out there. And she's obsessed with my cleanser, which is a huge honor. And so she said, did you create it based on another cleanser? Like, what did you use to clean your face with before? And I said, to be honest, I never used anything to clean my face. I would just use water. And sometimes I would do like an exfoliation with some kind of product, or I would then, start to use brown sugar when I got more natural. And she said to me, she goes, don't tell anyone that a skincare person like yourself never used a cleanser. And that's how I was raised. My mom said, you just wash your face with water. Sometimes you use soap, but just rinse it with water. And I don't wear a lot of makeup, so I didn't really feel the need to. But so anyway, then I created this cleanser, and I cannot live without it. So I clean my face with this at night, take off, including my eye makeup. Not that I wear a ton, but I've definitely done plenty of photo shoots and gotten ready for television and all sorts of things. And they take on a lot of makeup, and my facial cleanser takes it all off. It's amazing. So I use that, and it's also very hydrating. It doesn't dry the skin. I use that at night, and then I pile on my anti-aging facial oil. I also use my Amy Raut Beauty eye cream, which is amazing and thick and luscious. It's so good. Cocoa butter and ghee are the main ingredients. It's delicious. And then I probably will apply some of my Amy Raut Beauty lip balm, which I use ghee in three products. This is one of them, the eye cream and the anti-aging facial oil. It's like butter for your lips. It is so damn good. So that's what I'll apply before bed. And when I wake up in the morning, I just splash my face with water. I don't cleanse again. Occasionally, I'll probably like two or three times a week, I exfoliate with my organic coconut sugar facial scrub, which I'm obsessed with. I did exfoliate this morning, so you can my skin, I think, looks pretty good and fresh. I love it. And again, that's oil-based, so there's coconut oil in there, so it leaves the skin really hydrated, which is super nice. And then I'll apply my anti-aging facial oil, and I will apply to my entire body my Amy Raut Beauty body butter. It's basically shea butter and coconut oil whipped with some essential oils, and so it can be a little greasy, and so I'll apply it naked, kind of walk around, do my makeup, and then get dressed. That way it doesn't get on any of my clothing. Some people feel like it's too thick, so they'll just use it at night before bed, which is great as well. That's not my regimen, but works for a lot of people. And see, let's see. So, and then let's get into makeup. So I do not have my own makeup line, so I use other people's makeup. This is what I use for deodorant. Crystal Essence Roll-On. Non-toxic, aluminum-free, free of parabens, hypoallergenic, yada, yada, yada. Super clean. Where did that go?
Anyway. So, makeup.
I use a brand. This is my favorite brand, and one of my favorite people makes it, Diane Reed. It's called Modern Minerals. So, this is their Medium Almond Foundation. It's powder, non-toxic, pure enough to eat. You don't really want to eat it, but you could. I take a couple, I basically put a couple
splats of the powder
in my hand, and then one or two squirts of my anti-aging facial oil, massage together, and that's how I apply my foundation. So I kind of make my own liquid foundation every single morning. The owner of this company does the same thing, but she uses my cleanser. She is obsessed with my cleanser as her application for her powder to make her own
liquid foundation, if you will.
So
then I use, this is her bronzer.
The label has worn off because I'm so obsessed with it. But anyway, I use her bronzer. I use a nice little bamboo coarse hair brush. I use Modern Minerals eyeshadow to fill in my eyebrows because I'm still growing this one in, which you might be able to see. I was outside playing with James and makeup isn't really on. I use Bare Minerals. This is their Lash Dominance. This is their mascara. It's a very good mascara. It's the only non-toxic one that doesn't flake on me. I think it scores a 2 on
EWG site. I use
100% Pure. This is their liquid eyeliner. amazing, does not flake. I don't have it on right now, but like if I, we went out to dinner last night, so I wore it last night. I use Modern Minerals. This is their highlighter. So again, super clean, non-toxic makeup, but it's, you know, it's got that little like shimmer effect. So nice. I put it here and here. And
that gives me just a nice little
sparkle and glow. Love that. What else is in here? Oh, someone asked about nail polish. Right now, I'm pretty obsessed with Deborah Lipman. I also will use butter. I'll use Julep. But I'll tell you, Deborah Lipman does not chip like those other ones. And it's, I think it's 6-free, so it's free of all the major nasty chemicals, which is amazing. And
that's really all I have in here.
I have some other shadows from Modern Minerals that sometimes I'll use, but I'm really not a big makeup person. I am obsessed with this by RMS. It is their, it's called Sublime. It's their lip shine. Literally, it's like color, non-toxic color, castor oil, a little bit of beeswax. I think I'm going to try to replicate it.
And I use that, see that nice little
shimmer on my lips? I also am obsessed with my very own tinted lip butter. This is my rose
cinnamon.
In that, when I make this, I use Modern Minerals, this company, her Orchid Blush. So I use that to tint, and it's an amazing color on your lips. And it, like, I'll do that during the day. It just gives a nice little shine to my lips with a little bit of color for the tint. I don't know if you can see that in the light. Kind of like a rosish color. You can see it in comparison to the regular lip balm, so you see the coloring. So the ingredients are exactly the same, except for I added color to this one.
So those are mine.
And then for perfume, I use my Amy Raut Beauty Aromatherapy. This is my love stick, and I just put that on my wrist and on my neck. I love the smell. I have three different scents. There's chill, love, and happy. And the scents are meant to bring those emotions up for you, which is so nice. So let's see. Oh, dry shampoo. I sometimes just use arrowroot powder or baby powder with a talc. It's not so good, right? So I basically will try to use arrow powder. But I found out about this brand, which is, it's called
Hair Dance. The ingredients are organic
rice starch, organic oatmeal, lavender oil, and olive oil. But it's not oily at all. It's a powder, but it's a dry shampoo because I do not wash my hair on a regular basis. Maybe I wash it like once or twice a week. Another thing I wanted to mention that I use before I go to bed is my very own, I'm making my own magnesium oil now.
So I don't know if you guys have heard about
magnesium oil, but it's really good. Most of us are walking around with a magnesium deficiency that we don't realize we have.
Is the high pigmentation.
I'm not sure what that means, Beth. I don't know what high pigmentation means, but it doesn't leave a lot of color. No, it's just kind of like a little sheen. I love it.
But so magnesium,
we all tend to be a little deficient, and things show up for us if we're magnesium deficient. Like we get muscle cramps easily, or our muscles feel like, you know, we have to stretch them all the time. Like, they're not as, like, supple as they could be. We can have a little constipation or some restless sleep. And so I started using magnesium oil. This was the brand I originally was using. And I still recommend this brand. It's a great brand, Ancient Minerals. I get it on Amazon. I got it from my husband because he isn't the best sleeper. Like, he falls asleep and then he wakes up and then he's kind of restless. And so we were using the magnesium oil on him. You spray it on your feet before you fall asleep, like 3 squirts on each foot. I also always recommend magnesium in pregnancy because it really helps with those muscle cramps and it helps just kind of soften everything a little more so you're not so, you tend to get very crampy and muscle aches and pains in pregnancy, and the magnesium really helps with that, and sometimes women get constipation. So anyway, started using it on my husband, and then I started using it on myself, and I'm a great sleeper, but what I notice is I sleep even deeper now. Like, I am out, and I just feel so good and refreshed. And those people that tell you you never sleep again when you have a baby, it's not true. I mean, I sleep great. So then I made it myself. And what I'm doing is, you can kind of see there's like a little blue hue. It's kind of up top. So I'm making my own magnesium oil, which is basically magnesium salts diluted in distilled water. You boil the water. There's a little process to making it. And then I'm adding essential oil of blue chamomile because the chamomile is very settling at night and it's very calming to the nervous system, as is the magnesium. So it's kind of like packs another punch. Well, anyway, this is now what we're using, and we spray that on us before bed.
Oh, James. So I'm super anal, obviously, about what goes on
James's skin, my son, because he is, you know, a new person and very susceptible to all of the influences from the environment. So before he was born, I created Amy Ralph Baby Butt Butter, which has this kind of
yellowish color to it because
there's a little golden seal in there, which helps with diaper rash or any, you know, irritations on their butt or skin. And so it's basically olive oil, calendula oil,
a little shea butter,
a little beeswax to make it stick on, and the golden seal, which is just like this poignant yellow color. Oh my God, it's so good. He's literally never had diaper rash. The only time he's ever had diaper rash is when we were out of that, or if I put one of the more, like, you know, dare I say, toxic diapers on him, the ones that have the dyes and the chemicals. He wears a brand called Andy Pandy diapers, and they're bamboo, and they're biodegradable. They have no coloring or anything on them. I love them. I'm obsessed with them. They're a little more expensive than, like, say, Pampers. They're probably about 30 cents a diaper, but amazing. And so we use this on James's skin, on his butt. I use my body butter for his moisturizer because it's super clean. I make an unscented one for him. And that's about it,
you know.
So that's, you know, what he uses. And so Mother's Day is coming up, right? And I'm super excited. I created a mama basket of my Amy Ralph Beauty gift, a mama basket for Mother's Day for either mothers-to-be or new moms. And I put in all my essential mama items. And so you're going to get, in the basket, you get a sugar scrub. You get
an eye cream,
because what mom doesn't want to have non-puffy eyes that are glowing? And then a little exfoliation never hurts, especially when you're a brand new mom, because you're not sleeping that well. Like, I'm a mom of a 19-month-old, so I sleep pretty good. I am putting in my brand new magnesium oil, which is not even available for sale yet, which is amazing. We're giving everyone a 2-ounce, this is about 8 ounces, we're giving everyone a 2-ounce sample of the baby butt butter, so you can try that. Then we're putting in my Amy Ralph Beauty belly butter, which is amazing for a pregnant woman to avoid stretch marks, but it's also really good postpartum to help your body get back, your belly to get back and to have no stretch marks. Because that's a big thing. Women forget. They hydrate the crap out of their skin when they're pregnant because they want to avoid stretch marks. And then after they have the baby, they stop doing that, and then that's when the stretch marks sit in. So I still apply the belly butter to my belly every day, and I'm, you know, over a year and a half out. Since having the baby, but I don't have a single stretch mark, which is awesome. What else do I put in there? Oh, and in the mama gift basket. So then there's this chill aromatherapy stick, so that way they can be chill and calm as a new mom or mom-to-be, the best.
And I think that's it. Let's see.
One sugar scrub, one eye cream, one chill aromatherapy stick. Oh, one belly butter, baby butt butter, magnesium oil. And voila, that's the mama gift basket that is available right now. We have our Mother's Day sale that I think starts today, and is it 20% off, Beth, or 25%? I can't believe I can't remember. I'm so sorry. But if you want to go on amyroutbeauty.com, or if you want to try any of the products I've been talking about. So if you want to just try my stuff, we have my Amy Ralph Beauty Discovery Kit, which is actually free. All you have to do is pay for shipping. Go on amyroutbeauty.com and you'll see the pop-up come up. Enter put the discovery kit in your cart. Use the promo code FREE.
And all you do is pay for shipping, and I'll
send you my discovery kit. And that you can try all my facial oils, my cleanser, and my toner. So that's a really good deal. But also right now, everything on the site is 25% off with the code MAMALOVE, MOMMALOVE, because I love all you mamas. And like I said, the basket is an amazing gift. It's $111 full price, so 20% off, 25% off. You know, you get it for a nice deal. And on my site, any purchases over $75 is free shipping in the U.S., so get your shop on, girls. But anyway, that's what I do every day, and I feel really good about my skincare routine. I get compliments on my skin all the time. I am 42 and a half. Don't really have any wrinkles. I mean, a little. I like these, the little crow's feet. I think they're kind of pretty.
And I feel really good about my makeup and my skincare because I know that nothing I put on my body is toxic. So nothing's getting into my bloodstream and nothing's disrupting my hormones. And that feels really good to me. So anyway, loved having you guys. Again, amyrobbeauty.com. Everything's 25% off now for the next couple days. Now through May 8th. And like I said, get your shop on amyrobbeauty.com.
I will see you guys next week.
Any questions, anything, comments, any products that you are using that you love, put it in the comments below. I'll circle back later in the day and I'll answer. And thanks again. And I'll see you guys next week, okay? Have a wonderful day.